Hello and welcome to today's lecture for CS303 operating systems. Today we are going to cover chapter 8 and lecture 4. So once again, welcome to CS303, chapter number 8, lecture number 4. So the topic for today is paging, right? So just to give you a bit of background to revise what we have discussed so far. In a typical computer system, we have two kinds of address spaces. One of them is called the virtual address space. The other is called the physical address space. So virtual address space corresponding to the virtual memory, right? And the physical address space corresponding to the main memory. So as such, in order to execute a process, we know that the process has to be brought into memory. So whether we are talking about instructions or data, all of that has to be brought into main memory from, let's say, the disk or some IO devices and so on. So we have to bring process into memory, which typically means we have to translate a virtual address to a physical address, right? So this address translation has to be done, right? Now the question is, we have this requirement that processes need to be brought into main memory, right? And we also know due to because of multi-programming, at any point of time we can have multiple processes within the main memory, some user and some kernel, right? So which means that we need a way to manage this main memory, right? So essentially one of the main things here is how are we managing memory among processes. In other words, how are we allocating memory to various processes, right? So one of the techniques we discussed was CMA or contiguous memory allocation. So where the restriction was that each process that needs memory, physical memory, is allocated physical memory, but in one block, one chunk, right? Which means we cannot have parts of a process lying around in different areas of main memory. So we discussed contiguous memory allocation, first fit algorithms, worst fit algorithm, best fit algorithm. And one of the problems we saw there was that of fragmentation, right? So we had, once we had these series of allocations and delocations, after a while, if we look at the memory map, it can become highly fragmented, which means we have a number of scheduling, a number of memory holes, which may be, when added, may be enough to allocate to a large process. But the way they are located, due to the restriction that we are allocating contiguous memory in one block, because these holes are scattered, and in entirety one hole is not enough to allocate to a process, so we have this fragmentation problem. So we saw we can do things like compaction, but they are quite expensive. So a better solution, and one that is used in modern systems, is to relax the assumption that all the memory, all the physical memory that has to be allocated to a process has to be allocated in one block. So relax that assumption. So which means wherever we have physical memory, we allocate it to a process, even if it is at different locations. So with this in mind, now allowing non-contiguous memory allocation, we discussed a scheme called paging, right? So the virtual memory is divided into fixed size blocks called pages, and physical memory is divided into blocks of the same size called frames, right? So now we have to sort of do a mapping that this virtual page matches with this particular frame. So this is what we call address translation. So when the CPU generates a virtual address, then we have to, first of all, we have to map it to a physical address, right? So we have to map the virtual page to a physical frame, and then we have to make a note of that mapping in the page table. So page table will contain a list of all virtual to physical mappings for that particular process. So now whenever the CPU generates a virtual address, we look up the page table, get the corresponding physical address, and then we do our operation. Because eventually we have to bring that process into main memory. So if you're talking about a virtual page, the question is which physical frame do we bring it into? So the page table provides us with this answer. So today we look at paging in more detail and along with some examples. Okay. So now I am on slide 2, and this slide we also had in the previous lecture, but I'm just including it to sort of have this at the back of our minds. So this is our paging hardware. As we mentioned, this paging does require hardware support, and here we have is a page table. Okay. So we'll see that this page table can be stored in main memory or maybe in cache, right? So we'll be talking about that. So what we are seeing here is the translation being done with the virtual address, virtual or logical, they mean the same, being translated to its corresponding physical address. So the virtual thing we have is the virtual block we have is called the page, and the physical for each virtual block or virtual page we have a physical frame. So right now we assume that for each virtual page we have already allocated frames and their entries are there in the page table. Okay, so mappings have already been done. So if we go a bit later in the chapter, we'll see how we can create those mappings in the first place. But for now, we assume the virtual to physical mapping is already done, which means the page table is already populated, and we just have to do a simple page table lookup. So it's a data structure, this page table. We have to do a lookup. Why do we want to look up the page table? Because for each virtual address that is generated, we need the corresponding physical address. So what we have is, we saw that the logical address and physical address, so both have a certain size, let's say 32 bits. And the logical address has two components. One is page number, other is the page offset, right? And what we saw was that certain number of bits reserved for page number, certain number of bits reserved for offset. So from the virtual address we extract the page number, right? Page number 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. And then using that page number as an index, we look up the page table. So for page number X, we look at the row with X as its index. And then for that particular row, we see the value of F, which is a starting base address for the corresponding physical frame. Once we have that F, then we just combine it with the offset. So in the last lecture, we saw that the D parts for both addresses will be exactly the same, right? Because here we are doing addressing at a byte level. Each memory location addresses one byte. That is the level of granularity that we have. So which means byte number 1 in a particular virtual page X will always map to byte number 1 only in physical frame Y. Likewise, byte 10 of the virtual page maps to byte 10 of the virtual byte 10 of the physical frame. Right, so that we saw, therefore that is the reason that the D parts are same. So once we have F, once we have D, now we have generated our physical address, and now we go to that physical address and perform the operation. So in this way, we can translate a virtual address to a physical address. Okay. So perhaps we go to the physical address, then we do execute some instruction, maybe a load or store or do some arithmetic, you know, do whatever. Okay. Okay, so now I am on on slide 3. So now we are going to look at a very simple example. Okay. To illustrate this paging, this mapping. So paging model of logical and physical memory. So remember, logical is just another name for virtual memory. Okay. We will be talking more about virtual memory in the next chapter. So here what we have is a logical memory has been divided into four pages of a certain size, right? And page numbers start from zero, not from one. So just a convention. So logical memory has been divided into four pages. Okay. So depending on what size you have of your memory, and depending on what size of page you choose, you can have, you know, number of pages. So for example, if you have a very small one, if you have 32 byte of memory and your page size is 4k, if you have 32 kb of main memory and your page size is 4kb, then how many pages will you have in that address space? So 32 by 4 8. So like that we can do calculations, we'll soon see. So we have four pages, and on the next we have the page table, right? Towards the right, the middle, the page table. And what are the indexes here? Now we see 0, 1, 2, 3. So the page number is used as an index to look up into the page table. Okay. So we have so page numbers, right? So we have four pages. So the natural values for the page numbers are 0, 1, 2, and 3. And you know, once we look up that with that page number as the index, we get the corresponding frame number. Okay. And then that tells us, you know, where at physical memory we have to go to. So this is just a very simple starting example. In the later examples, we'll take an actual address, an actual 32-bit address, and then we'll do this paging on it by extracting the page number and offset. So those examples are coming. So we can see page 0 maps to which frame? Frame 1. Page 1 maps to which frame? Frame 4. Okay, so remember, virtual pages and physical frames. Page 2 maps to frame 3. Page 3 maps to frame 7. So here you can see the physical memory. Its size is shown as larger than logical memory. Generally, it's the reverse. The virtual memory is a lot bigger. Okay. So here, you know, obviously, half of the physical memory is allocated, the other half is available. Right. So this could be looked at all the pages of a particular process. Right. So what you have in the memory map is for each process, you have a bunch of pages being assigned to, you know, certain frames, and like this you have allocations for each and every process. So note that each and every process has its own page table. Okay. So this is, you know, how we are doing the lookup. If I want to know where you know, the mapping for page 3, so I use 3 as the index in the page table, and then it page 3 maps to frame 7. Then frame 7, whatever its address is, you know, I that is my address. Okay. So now I am on slide number 4, and here we are just talking about the previous picture. So we have a so here we have a physical memory of size 32 bytes. Okay, 32 bytes, and page size of 4 bytes. So physical memory, once again, size is 32 bytes and size of page is 4 bytes. So generally there's multiples of each other, and so that we get an exact number of pages. So therefore, how many pages can be fit into this physical memory? Very simple, 32 by 4, 8 pages. And now let's assume we have a logical or virtual memory, assuming the same size of a page, 4 bytes. Then we can fit in. So the size of the logical memory now is 16 bytes. Okay. So let's assume we have 4 pages, as we saw, page 0 to page 3, and 8 frames, frames 0 to frame 7. Size of both the page and the frame are equal, which is 4 bytes, right, which is 32 bits. Okay, so size of a page and a frame is 4 bytes. So note, what is basically happening is we have a certain amount of memory, whether it's physical memory or virtual memory, and we are dividing it into equal size blocks, equal size chunks, is what we are doing, right? So if you have a 4 GB of memory, and if your page size is 4K, as it generally is, so then how many pages can you have? 4 GB divided by 4K, you can do the math. So that's all we are doing. We are dividing our memory into equal size blocks, okay, for allocation. Each block can then be allocated to a process. Okay. So, process A may need 6 blocks. Process B may need 12 blocks. Process C may need 16 blocks, and so on, based on the requirements. But we allocate them in terms of blocks. Okay. So now, logical address 0. Right. Well, let me see this. I think this explanation is probably for the next example. So I think let's look at the next example first, and then we will look at this explanation. Okay. So once again, this material for slide 4, this is for the next example number 2. So let us discuss the picture for that, and then we will look at the text. Okay, so now we look at this example 2. So we are on slide 5 now. Okay, so here we have this is a paging example of a 32 byte memory with 4 byte pages. So when we say 32 byte memory, we mean physical memory. So size of my physical memory is 32 bytes. Size of our page is 4 bytes. Right. So how many pages can we have? 32 byte memory, 4 byte pages. 8 pages we can have. So here we see the mapping, logical memory mapping to physical memory. And the page table shows the mapping. So if you see, the page size is 4 bytes, which means it can, of course, contain 4 bytes of data, right? So therefore we see these 4 characters in there. So one character, 1 byte, right? 4 characters, 4 bytes. So now we see the mapping. So naturally, on the left we have our virtual pages, right, on the extreme left. In the middle we have the page table, which shows for a particular page which physical frame it maps to. And then if you see the contents are exactly the same, right? So page 0, which frame does it map to? Maps to frame 5. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Frame 5 starting at address 20. So you can see, for the physical memory, the addresses also have a number now. In reality, these addresses are hexadecimal, but here we're just using decimals for just ease of explanation. So which means for the first physical frame, the addresses are 0, 1, 2, 3. For second frame, addresses are 4, 5, 6, 7 and likewise. For the last frame, addresses are 28, 29, 30, 31. And each address holds one byte of information. Right? I hope it's clear. So now let's try to see our mapping. And likewise, logical also we have addresses. Right? So for the logical ones, the addresses are going from 0 to 15. Why? Because what is the size of the logical memory? 16 bytes. And we know one address per byte. So we will have 16 addresses. 0 to 15. So which means the logical addresses, they run from, what is the range? They run from 0 to 15. For physical addresses, what is their range? They run from 0 to 31. So we have a mapping. So 0 in logical maps to which one in physical? 15 in logical maps to which one in physical? Those are the questions. So now let's see logical address 0. What does logical address 0 store? A. So each of them are storing characters. So logical address 0 storing A. Right? So here what's the page number? Page number is 0. What is the offset? Offset is also 0. So remember, using the offset, we can access individual bytes within a page or within a frame. So the granularity of access is at the level of bytes. We can access individual bytes. So A is page 0, offset 0. Likewise, B is page 0, offset 1, right? So that's how it works. E is page 1, offset 0. P is page 3, offset 3, right? So like that this works. Now the question is, we have to find out, we have to see what is the mapping for A. So A we see is page 0, offset 0. So looking at the page table, page 0 corresponds to which physical frame? Frame 5. And if we start at the top, what is the starting address for frame 5? So frame 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the starting address for frame 5 is 20. So now we have located the F part. So remember, going back, the virtual address has two components, P and D. So in this case, those are 0 and 0. 0 for page number, 0 for offset. And 0, the 0 in P corresponds to 5 in frame. So we get the address, the F part is now 20. Right? And then offset is 0, so therefore, which means logical address 0 corresponds to physical address 20. Right? So we can easily get that. They're all contiguous. So 5 into 4, right? It's frame 5. And the size of each is 4, so 20. Size of each page. Likewise, what about D? Mapping for D in logical. So D corresponds to page 0, offset 3. Page 0, offset 3. So page 0 again, the base physical address is 20. Offset 3, add 3 to it, 23. So this way we do mapping. For E in logical, page 1, offset 0. Page 1 corresponds to frame 6. Frame 6, 24. Offset 0 stays 24. For N, last one. So 0, 1, 2, 3. Page 3, offset 1. Page 3, frame 2. Frame 2 means 8. Right? 8 is a starting physical address. Offset is 1, 9. So in this way, using this page table, we can do mappings between our virtual address and physical address. Okay. So I hope this example is clear. Right. The technique is the virtual address has two components, page number and offset. We use the page number to look up the corresponding frame number in the page table, and then we get the address of that. Right. In reality, the page table contains the address. Here, just for simplicity, we have just shown the frame number, right, and then we get the address, the base address. So for frame 5 it's 20, for frame 6 it's 24, for frame 1 it's 8, and for frame 2 it's, I'm sorry, for frame 1 it's 4, and for frame 2 it's 8. And then we just add the offset to get the final physical address. Okay. Okay, now I am on page number 6, and now we can look at sort of the number of bytes we have in our various addresses. Okay, so let's assume that our logical address space, right, is 2^m bytes. Okay. And our page size is 2^n bytes. So logical address space is 2^m bytes, and page size is 2^n bytes. So looking at our previous example, what are the values for m and n? Right. So if you see in the previous example, the logical address space, what was its size? It was 16 bytes. So 16 bytes is, can be rewritten as 2^4. So which means m is equal to 4. And page size is, was 4 bytes, which is 2^2. So 2 is n. I'm sorry, 2 is n. So m is 4, n is 2. Now what we are saying is, how many bits are needed in the logical address, so as to address each and every byte of the logical address space, right? So one observation we make is that which I've written down, an address comprising of x number of bits can successfully address 2^x bytes. Okay, so we know that each memory location, each memory address is mapped to one byte of data, right? So like we saw for integers, the size of an integer, the general size is it's 4 bytes, right? So that means we need a block of 4 bytes, right? 4 addresses. So for simplicity, 100, 101, 102, 103, all together, of course. So 100 to 103 is the address space for that one integer, right? So we have 4 locations, 100, 101, 102, 103, so which are referencing or addressing 4 bytes, one location, one byte. So we're saying x bit address or an address comprising of x number of bits successfully addresses 2^16 bytes. So which we have in our case, what, because our logical address space is 16 bytes, so which means our logical address needs how many bits? 4, right? So with 4 bits, what are all the addresses we can generate, all the logical addresses with 4 bits? So 0000 to 1111, so 0 to 15, right? Address numbers, so 0 to 15 in terms of decimal, and 0000 to 1111 in terms of binary, right? So each address addresses one byte. So we have 16 of these addresses, one after the other, so we address 16 bytes. So with 4 bits we can address 16 bytes. Likewise, in real systems, we have 32-bit address, we know. So that means we can address 2^16 32 bytes. So we'll see that that is in the gigabyte range. And now we know we have 64-bit machine, so 2 raised to 64 bytes is what can be addressed. Even terabytes are small, can easily be addressed. Okay. So now, so to address these 16 bytes in the logical address space, we need 4 bits. So which means our logical address is of 4 bits. Now the interesting thing is, in this 4-bit address, how many bits are taken up by the page number and how many bits are taken up by the offset? That is what we have to determine. We know that the number of bits we need to store the logical address is 4. So out of those 4 bits, what are the components for P and D? Right? Page number and offset. So for D, we can easily determine how many bits are needed for that. What we need is, we need to know the page size. Page size we know is 4 bytes. So in order to address 4 bytes, we need how many bits? Only 2, right? So 00, 01, 10, 11, right? So these are 4 addresses, we can address 4 bytes. So 2 bits are needed for addressing each and every byte within a particular page. So page size is 4 bytes, which means 4 bytes have to be addressed separately, which means we need, which means 2 bit addresses are sufficient. 2 bit offset is sufficient. So the offset is, so 00 for offset 0, 01 for offset 1, 10 for offset 2, 11 for offset 3. So out of those 4 bits, 2 are taken up by the offset D. What is left is 2 bits, which are taken up for the page numbers. So page number 2 bits, which means how many pages can we have? 2 raised to 4. So which again makes sense, because 16 byte address space, 4 byte page table, we can have 4 pages. So I hope this calculation makes sense. We have a logical address space of 16 bytes. So which means our logical address needs to have 4 bits. Out of those 4 bits, 2 bits are reserved for the offset, because the page size is 4 bytes. And so for representing the offset, we need 2 bits. 2 bits are left. Those are for representing the page number. Again, logical address space is 16 bytes. Page size is 4 bytes. So 16 by 4, we need to represent 4 pages, and 2 bytes are sufficient. So note that as the value of M and N changes, so would the value of P and D. But I hope this is clear. How do we get the number of bytes in the address, and you know, how we get the values for P and D. Okay. Now if you want to find out what is the page size of your system, on a Linux system, you can say getconf and then page size. So page size is a symbolic constant used for representing, you guessed it, page size. And what I get on my Linux machine is 4096. So this is generally given in terms of number of bytes. So page size is 4096 bytes, or 4K. Right? 4K is the page size. And if I type it on my Mac machine, I get the same thing, 4K. So if you want, you can also use a get page size system call within a program. Okay. Okay, now I am on slide 7. And we are looking at now is paging and fragmentation. So if you recall a couple of slides back, we said that major drawback of contiguous memory allocation is it has a significant amount of fragmentation. Right, external, which means it, which is external to a memory partition or block, and also internal partition within a block or a segment. Right? Block and segment are sort of synonyms. So now what we say is, so how does paging handle external fragmentation? First of all, So our claim is that yes, it does. If you use paging, there is no, if you choose the page size carefully, there is no external fragmentation. So as we saw in the previous example, logical address space 16 bytes, page size 4 bytes, 4 pages. So with 4 pages, we totally cover the 16 bytes and our external fragmentation is totally eliminated. Right? So I hope you can see that, how paging ensures that external fragmentation is totally eliminated. Right? So external fragmentation occurs because of the restriction of allotting processes to contiguous memory holes. So in the contiguous location, we said that, okay, fine, you know, this process needs, let's say, for example, 8 bytes of storage, of memory. I have 4 bytes lying around here, 4 bytes lying somewhere else, which are non-contiguous, but I cannot allot. Whereas in paging, I can easily allot 4 bytes in one location, 4 in the other. There's no problem. Okay, so it is all right for a process to be assigned memory that is, you know, non-contiguous physical memory. Any free frame can be allotted to a process that needs it. Okay, so as far as external fragmentation is concerned, we have effectively eliminated that. What about internal fragmentation? So if you think about it, internal to a partition, that fragmentation we can still have. Okay, because your page requirements may not be in terms of 4. So if you have 16 bytes and 4 byte page size, you can have 4 pages, but let's say memory requires 5 bytes. So naturally, one allocation of one page will not be enough. So you have to allocate 2 pages. And first page is utilized perfectly. In the second page, you have internal fragmentation of how much? Of 3 bytes. So what we are saying is, if the memory requirements of a process do not coincide with the page boundaries, right? So which in our case do not coincide with multiples of 4, the memory requirements of processes. So rather than asking for 4 or 8, it asks for 5 or 7. So then the last allotted frame may not be full. Okay. So we do have internal fragmentation. But it's bounded by, for each process, it's bounded by only one extra page, one extra frame. Okay, so it is still not that bad. Okay, so here I'm on slide 8. So again, to take an example to illustrate fragmentation with paging. Let's say we have a page size is 2KB. So we saw in our systems with 4K. So let's say it's 2K. So 2K is 2 into 2 raised to 10, which is 2 into 1024, which is 2048 bytes page size. How much memory will a process of 72766 bytes need? Well, simply divide and we'll see 35 pages will be full, and then 1086 bytes. Right? So in the 36th page, 962 bytes are unused. So internal fragmentation. Worst case, a process would need n pages plus 1 byte. So we would need to allocate n plus 1 frames. So wastage of at most almost 1 frame. So which as we say, still not bad. So as far as paging is concerned, it effectively tackles both kinds of fragmentation. External fragmentation, it totally eliminates. Internal fragmentation for a particular process is bounded by one extra frame. Okay. So now I am on slide number 9. And here we take another example of virtual to physical address translation. Okay. So this one is a bit more realistic, you can say. Numbers are a bit more realistic. So here what we have is, towards the left we have the virtual address space, towards the right we have the physical address space, right? So page size here is now the one which is actually used, which we just saw, 4K. Okay, so page size is 4K here. Okay, so how many bits are needed to correctly address 4KB, 4 kilobytes? So if you do the math, it will be 12 bits, because 2 raised to 12 is 4K, 4096. So 12 bits will be needed for the offset. Anyway, we'll come to those numerical examples later, but for now page size is 4K, which means whether it is the physical memory or whether it's the virtual memory, both will be divided into chunks of or blocks of 4K, because frame size is also 4K now. So virtual address space is 64 KB, and physical address space is looks like 32 KB. So therefore, for virtual address space, it's 64 KB, page size is 4 KB, so 16 pages we can have in the virtual address space. Physical space is 32 KB, page size is 4 KB, so we can have 32 by 4, 8 physical frames. So 16 pages on the left, 8, but availability of physical frames is 8, which kind of represents what happens in the real world. Number of frames will always be smaller than the number of pages. So here we see chopping of the memory, 0 to 4K, right? First chunk, second chunk, 4K to 8K, 8 to 12, 12 to 16, going all the way to 60 to 64K. And similarly, for the physical memory also, 0 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 12, 12 to 16, going all the way to 28 to 32K. Okay. And as you can see, we have only 8 frames, so only 8 pages are mapped. And the ones which are not mapped, we have an X. The ones which are mapped, the physical frame number is shown. So where if we look at the physical memory and read the physical frames, when we go from bottom to top, the numbers increase. So we have 0 at the bottom, then 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so the bottom one, 0K to 4K, this virtual page maps to frame number 2. 4K to 8K maps to frame number 1, and so on. Okay, so how would the addresses look here? In the 0K to 4K, 0 to 4095. Okay, so note that because we are starting with 0, so the addresses for this 0K to 4K in both the virtual as well as physical address space would be 0 to 4095. So we have 12 bits. We can represent using those 12 bits. We can address 2 raised to 12 bytes of memory. We can address 4K. So the addresses, they will look like 0 to 4095. 0 will be the lowest. 4095 will be the highest. For 4K to 8K, the range will be 4096 to 8191. So it's in multiples of 4096, but the last one just falls short by 1 because we're starting with 0. 8K to 12K addresses range will be 8092 till 12287. Okay. So 0K to 4K address range is 0 to 4095. 4K to 8K address range 4096 to 8191. 8K to 12K address range is 8092 to 12287. Okay, so I hope that is clear. And now let's look at a mapping. Let's say we have a instruction that says MOV REG comma 0. So the instruction is MOV REG comma 0. So which means go to virtual address 0, get the contents and move them to the register named REG, right? Because it's in part of CPU proximity. So which means we have to access address, virtual address 0. But as we know, in our memory management, this will actually be mapped to a physical address. Right. So now which, so virtual address 0 is mapped to which physical address? That is the question. So if you look here, virtual address 0 will fall under the lowest page, 0k to 4k, and address is 0, so the first address there, which means the first byte in the first page, first virtual page, right? So the pages are arranged from bottom to top. So first byte in the first virtual page. Okay. So we can say page number is 0, offset number is also 0. Now when we see the mapping, so we have not, so here we don't have a page table node, here we only have the mappings. So page table will come in the next slide. So here what we see is this is the first page is mapped to the second frame. I'm sorry, frame number 2. It's not the second, it's the third frame. Frame number 2. So frame 0, frame 1, frame 2. So for frame, physical frame 2, what is the range of addresses? For physical frame 2, range of addresses is 8k to 12k. Which means the actual addresses are 8192 to 12287. So I'm sorry if I said 8092 previously. The range for 8k to 12k will be 8192 to 12287. So you can double check that. So which means that virtual address 0 corresponds to physical address 8192, right? Because the offset is 0, nothing to add. So which means move reg comma 0 transforms to move reg comma 8192, right? 8192. So in this way, you know, we can do the mapping. If we had physical virtual address 1, then an offset of 1 would have applied, and then so which means page 0 offset 1, which means frame 2 offset 1, which means 8192 plus 1, 8193. So we are accessing individual bytes. So that move reg 0 would have mapped to move reg comma 8193. So likewise, if you do third for move reg comma 8192. So where 8192 is the virtual address. So 8192 means the, you know, 8k to 12k and no offset. It's the very first address, 8192. 8k to 12k maps, so this maps to page 6, which is 24k to 28k. So the very first address in this 24k, which if I multiply 24 into 1k, which is 1024, so 24576. So 8192 virtual address maps to 24576 physical address. Right. So in this way, we see good mapping between virtual addresses and physical addresses. So I hope you know this example is clear, right? So here 64 kilobyte of virtual memory, 4 kilobyte page size, so 16 pages, 32 kilobyte of physical memory, 4 kilobyte of frame size, so 8 frames. Okay. So now we are on slide 10, which will probably be our last slide for today's lecture. And here what we are doing is we are showing the contents of the page table. Because remember that ultimately we saw that ultimately the mapping of virtual address to physical address happens by looking at the page table. The page table contains that mapping. So now what we have is internal operation of MMU, memory management unit, with 16 4 kilobyte pages. So virtual address space we saw was 64 kilobyte. Page size is 4 kilobyte, so we can have 16 pages. Right. So another way of looking at it is 64 kilobyte of virtual memory is chopped up into 16 pieces of 4 kilobyte each. So now what we have is ultimately what we need is a mapping between virtual to physical address. So now we look at, so again those addresses are given in terms of, although we are using decimal values. Like last example, we used a zero, address zero. But here, they're actually binary. So here we look at incoming virtual address 8196. Okay. So now if you convert 8196 to binary, this is what you get. Right, it's written over here. 001000000000100. So this is the virtual address. Now we know that the page size is 4 kilobyte, which means 2 raised to 12 bytes, which means we need 12 bits. So remember, with a 12 x bits in the address, we can address 2 raised to x bytes of memory. So with the 12 bits, we can address 2 raised to 12 bytes or 4 kilobytes. So 12 bits of the virtual address will be reserved for the what? The offset. Because within this 4KB block, within this 4KB page, we want to address each and every individual byte. Right? So we need 12 bits. Right? So all zeros, one after the other 12, to address byte 1. All ones. So a set of 12 ones, one after the other, to address byte number 4095. So 12 bits we reserve for the offset, right? And we have total 16 bits. So how many bits left for the page number? 16 minus 12, 4. So which again the calculation is correct, because with the 4 bits, we can represent 16 page numbers, and that is what we have. We have 16 4KB pages. So now we see zeros. So we graph. So from this virtual address, we extract the page number, higher order 4 bits, 0010. So page number is 2. 0010 evaluates to 2. Page number 2. So page number 2 is used. 2 is used as an index into the page table. And for page number 2, the corresponding base address starting is 110. Okay. So here we have one bit for present absent. So we mark as present, otherwise we mark as absent. So for example, if you see page 60K to 64K, there is no mapping. So which happens to be page number 16. So for that is 0. Page 15 also 0. I'm sorry, page 16 is, because we're starting with 0, page 16 is actually 15 here. So for pages 15, 14, 13, 12, you can see there's no mapping. Right. But for this particular page, page 0, mapping is there. So the present absent bit is mapped, is marked as 1. Rest we have 010, so which means 010 is the starting physical address. So which we just copy, 110, not 010. So essentially what we are doing here, let's look at it again. We have an incoming virtual address of 16 bits. 12 bits are reserved for the offset, and the first 4 bits are the page number. We extract those, and the value there is 0010, which is 2. So page number 2. We use 2 as the index and look up the base physical address, which is 110. Okay. So 110 is 2 raised to 1 plus 2 raised to 2, which is 5. Right. So this 110 we take. Not 5, it is actually 6, right? So 2 raised to 1 plus 2 raised to 2 is 6. So what we are saying is page 2 maps to frame 6, which is correct if you look at the diagram. So then we take this 110, this becomes the F value that we were talking about, base physical address, and offset we copy as it is, as you know we had looked at earlier. And so we have an outgoing physical address, right? So in this way, a virtual address can be mapped to a physical address by looking at the page table. And one thing you will note here is how many bits are there in the virtual and physical addresses. Virtual address 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 bits, right? Because we need 16 bits, because 16 bits can effectively address 2 raised to 16 bytes, which is 2 raised to 10 into 2 raised to 6 bytes. 2 raised to 10 is 1K, so 2 raised to 6 KB, kilobytes, and 2 raised to 6 is 64 kilobyte. So to access each and every byte within those 64 kilobytes, we need 16 bit addresses. So that is for the virtual address. Now, one interesting thing you'll notice, the physical address does not have 16 bits, it has only 15 bits. And reason for that is because, again, what is the size of the physical address space? It is 32 kilobyte. So for 32 kilobyte, we need one less bit than 16, we need 15. So, you know, what that tells us is within the address, we may have some bits which are unnecessary, which are not required, and they can be used for other purposes as well. Yeah, what are those purposes? We'll soon see. So the physical address is only 15 bits, because that's all we need to effectively address 32 KB. Okay, so I hope, you know, this address translation is clear, right?